Righty ho. What we're going to do is a left hand loop. So we're doing junctions turning left.
Nice.
All the time, no left. And we're going to build on the routine that we started before. A hazard drill. So we'll be turning in there, turning in and emerging. So it's mirror, signal, position, speed, gear, lug. And then decide whether we're going to go or not. If we're going to go, foot goes to gas. If not, you've got your foot over the brake already. Clutch just goes gently down and we stop. So this first junction we're coming to, is that open or closed, do you think?
It's closed because of houses.
Yeah, it's difficult to see. As we get to the end, it might open up a bit. So, how do you think we're going to approach this?
Probably the same as we did before, with the ones where we're turning out.
Yeah.
So just assume that there's something coming.
Yeah. Certainly in these early stages, when we're doing the little loop, just come in dead steady. And put yourself in a position where you can stop if you need to or go if you need to. If you're a little bit too slow, doesn't really matter, because what we're doing is we're building up the routine. But I'll talk you through the first ones, and then we'll gradually hand that responsibility to you. When you're ready to take it.
Should I just left that up?
When you're ready, make your normal checks, and off we go. Onwards and upwards.
Yep.
Or at the very least, sideways.
Sideways. You're funny. But there's a lot of people on this estate.
That's fine. Better too much than not enough.
No.
Ah, well spotted. He didn't signal, did he?
Nope.
Little tinker.
I'm just going to assume that everyone's a hazard.
Okay. Well done.
Oh, good job he was indicating.
So we're going to go left at the end of the road. What do you suppose these guys are going to do?
Be incredibly annoying and...
You've done exactly the right thing. Let's just haul back and get them out of our way. So from this point, you just pop your right foot over the brake. Not necessarily squeezing it. You can see we've got a restricted view.
Oh, that's horrible.
Just let it trundle in.
He's not going to like me. I don't care though.
So right for traffic, left to help with our position. Well, do you think we can go?
Yeah.
Follow the road of the line of the kerb round and off we go. Brilliant. Bang on. Well done.
Oh good, it comes off by itself.
Yes, and then all the other things. Yeah, go on up to third.
I'll wait until I go
home. Oh, okay.
Speed.
Well, we're going to take the next road on the left. Oh, check out mirrors. Signal to the left. Get out of position right. Right foot over the brake. Down in a second. Loads of time. Clutch smoothly back up. Look into the road. Right foot still on the brake until you decide you're going to go. Can we go?
Yep.
Follow the line of the curb around. Well done.
Pretty bumps.
Next road on the left. That's good. How did that feel?
All right, easy.
Good.
Easy enough.
How about the speed as we came around the corner?
Bit too fast.
Okay. If you put your right foot over the brake a little longer.
Yeah, then I probably could have pulled the brake a little bit as
that's
well.
That's fine.
Left as well, again?
Yeah, when we get to the end of the road, we'll take the road to the left. I think there's a turning to the left before that, isn't there? Yeah. So this time, some parked vehicles around.
Yeah.
So how are we going to approach that?
Cautiously.
Absolutely.
Because someone could be behind them as well.
Indeed. Well spotted. So if you look underneath, you can see there's nobody there.
Well, yeah, but yeah. It's better to be cautious.
It is. We'll go left to the end. So
there's lots
single. Right foot over the brake all the way in. We're probably going to use first this time. So a little bit more brake. That's it. Let's do it around. It's good.
I know I did that again, didn't I?
That's okay. So we're in a little quick.
Yeah.
So we just take
I'm leaving
bit
it too long.
That's
yeah.
Okay. It's fine. We'll turn left here.
That's it.
Yes, you can. So it's just learning, building up an experience of what speed you need. So if we've been a little slower there, you'd have more time. It's all about making time for yourself.
Yeah. Because I keep thinking the car's going to come to a stop when I come off there.
Yeah. We'll go left at the end of this road. Because there's so little, I mean, we're already in first, but if you're approaching here in second, you'll probably slow down here. Drop into first as you go there. So we get right foot over the brake. Just slow it down a little bit, just let it trundle. So no, go on, let it run. See how slow it'll go. Mm-hmm. Out of the gas in a minute. So you don't have to do anything with it.
I keep wanting to put the clutch in.
Of course you do.
Even though I don't need to.
That's right. So you only put the clutch in if you're going to stop or change gear. That's good. Well done. All about routines.
Just being a bit careful because this car's on his side.
It's completely fine. Completely fine. Once you get confidence in the routine, then we can build the extra speed and stuff on that we need. We're going to third. We have time. We go left at the end of the road.
There's no objection.
And we'll come in really slow like we did with that last one.
Yeah.
And just at the last minute, we'll just drop it into first.
Okay.
So get right foot over the brake. Just take a bit of speed off. A little bit more. Into first gear. You can still right foot over the brake. Can we go?
Yeah.
Once you decide, then foot goes to the gas. So it really will go very, very slow indeed.
Yeah, so that obviously gives me a bit more time to react if I need to.
You are indeed correct. A little bit severe, these bumps, aren't they?
They are, I was just thinking that. I'm trying to go over them, but the car's not big enough, no. So... My mum feel for that.
Next turning on the left. So again, as I right foot over the brake all the way on the way in. Well, depending on where you're at.
Well,
do you say, is this the right gear?
Yeah. Okay. Much better.
Splendid.
Much better.
Until the next road on the left. So again, mirror signal. Right foot over the brake. Down in a second. Squeeze the brake a little bit. Clutch smoothly back up. See how much time you have. Loads and loads. And we never worry about doing it slowly and people behind worry, you know, because that's what the L plates are for. That's bang on. Well done.
Your dog's on the side of the road.
Yeah.
Makes me terrified.
Learner drivers are always surprised to find out just how much time they've got.
It's strange, isn't it? Because I mean, you think you panic at the very last minute rather than actually thinking about it beforehand.
Well, it's experience, isn't it? That's all. So we're always trying to, if we look here, we're going to go left at the end of the road. We're always trying to work out on the way in. How much can I see? Is this going to be a second gear junction? Is it going to be a first gear? What do you think on this one?
Second. Maybe first.
Okay.
Should we put
that
on the first, do you think?
Yeah, cool. Mirror signal. Take a little bit more speed off. Drop it into first gear just now. Still braking. That's it. Can we go? So yeah, right foot over the brake all the way in until you've decided you're going to go.
Right.
That's it, good. Let's stay on this road this time. I think this takes us around the same place, you know.
It probably does. It looks like a big circular road anyway.
Well, I did that so we'll get a little bit more speed up. So let's see if we can get up through the gears on this road. I mean, obviously you can't go too fast because of it. So but just to give us an approach a little bit quicker into this junction at the end. At which we'll take the road leading to the left.
Okay.
So again, based on how much we can see, that determines the speed we come in. It'll trundle like this forever.
What, really, without us touching anything at all?
Yeah. It's just at the end, we'll drop it into first. Still right foot over the brake. Tuck the steering in. Can we go?
Yep.
There you go. Loads of time. What we'll do this time is we'll follow the road ahead.
Okay.
Obviously we'll find some different junctions. We're going to use the same one all the time, do we?
That'll be fun. Not knowing where I'm going.
Yeah. Well, that makes two of us.
Well, no, I mean, this is it, isn't it? You've got to be... These homes are horrible.
Well, the problem is they only slow down the sensible people.
Yeah, this is true.
We'll take the next turning on the left, or the next road on the left. So again, we're always trying to work out what we've got in front of us. Right foot shifts over the brake. What gear do you think we need here?
Two.
Go on then. Clutch smoothly back up. Fantastic.
Oh God, they're even bigger.
Even more severe bumps. We'll go left at the end of this rod. They are big, aren't they? Again, right foot goes over the brake. Just let it trundle in. Got quite a good view this time, haven't we?
Yeah.
Can we go? And that extra speed just helps you tidy everything up on the way,
yeah,
doesn't it?
Right, the car.
Again, that's a great approach. You just don't know what they're going to do, do you?
No. Because you just... Well, you do. Kids are unpredictable.
It's a little bit more. That's it. Well done.
Sorry.
It's all right.
Silly cars parked on...
How dare they?
Oh, this is awful being on this side
this
of the road.
This makes life awkward, doesn't it? So
yeah.
What we're going to be looking at is obviously watching for cars coming in the way, but you're looking for places
people.
Where you can stop.
Yeah.
If somebody comes now, there's nowhere for us to go, is there?
No.
So they would have
they
to
they would have to stop, yeah.
But if somebody comes now, we could probably move over.
Yeah. So
this is probably just about the right speed, isn't it?
Yeah, gives you time it gives to me react. A lot of time to stop, doesn't it?
Well done. Exactly the right thing to do. Until you were sure where he was.
Because he's so little, you know. I mean, all the kids generally do have a sense of road safety, but generally little kids don't, do they?
No, they don't.
I mean, I know what Jenny would do. She'd just run straight across.
Well, yeah, because they're not thinking about road safety, are they?
Nope.
They think, I want to be over there.
Their mums are horrible.
They are a bit severe.
So this would be 20, wouldn't it?
Actually, it's a 30. Which would be way too fast, wouldn't it?
Well, yeah, because, I mean, if you hit these at 30, you're going to go blind.
Yeah, it wouldn't do your car much good.
No. It's not going to do it much good at the minute, and I'm going over them at 20 miles.
Do you know how you can tell it's 30?
Is it the lights again?
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Bit
street lights
area.
Are nothing to tell you any different. We'll take the next turning on the left. And how much can we see?
Quite a bit.
Good.
And we're all right, so... Well, that wasn't odd.
I think it's a dead end.
Do you think?
It is, yeah. What we'll do is, when we get past this car, we'll just steer in to the right.
Right. Ooh. Yeah.
That's
not like
it.
That.
That's me. Spin it round. And then straighten up. That's a little tight. If you just let me have the control, I'll take this back. Nothing on the end of it, so this was a cul-de-sac.
Oh God, did I curve the wheels or just the tyre?
No, it's just the tyre.
Sorry then.
Ready, ho? When you're ready, you take the pedals.
Are we in first still?
We are.
Alright, it's alright.
So a nice gentle pull away and just steer around to the right. That's excellent. That's where your really good clutch control comes into play. You can control the speed around these corners. Oh, like around a situation like that. Why would you have your dog off the lead where there's traffic?
Because you've got a death wish, obviously, for the dog, that is.
Left at the end of this road, please.
Okay. I can see quite well, so...
It's good?
Well, apart from that one head, so I'll just come off.
So keep looking left as well, help with your positioning.
Yeah, we're good.
And as ever, you're always better off too slow than too fast. We'll take this road on the left, which is the one I meant to take in the first place.
This one?
Yes, please.
I think I'm hurting the car. It sounds like it's creaking.
No, that's the suspension creaking.
Oh, is it from the bumps?
Actually, forget that. Just carry straight on. I think this is... That's a dent in too, isn't it? Yes, it is.
How am I?
We'll just follow the road ahead. She's not faced with a choice but do that, is she?
No, because the cars...
Yeah.
I have to do that quite often and it makes me very nervous.
That's lovely clearance. Yeah, you're very vulnerable when you're out there, aren't you?
Well, this is it, especially with a pushchair. That's it. Mirror's rubbish. Better get under whoever gave it to you and tell them. This is so horrible, having to drive for so many cars.
Yeah, well, I mean, you're doing exactly the right thing by just keeping the speed down so that you're ready for anything that might happen. And that's always the danger in places like this where people live. If there's lots of cars like that, it obscures your view.
Yeah. I think he's going to go across.
I was just going to ask you the question. What do you think the little one's going to do?
I was going to beat Adam so that he knew I was there. Would that be all right?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. We'll take the next road on the left, please.
Oh, these...
Yeah, we'll get away from you. They're a bit severe.
Yeah, I've got loads of time.
Barbed wire on the top of everything. This mustn't be quite a very nice area.
It's not. This is the thing. That's what I meant about saying that we didn't want to live here.
And left at the end of this road. And that's a nice speed. Remember to keep looking left too. Fabulous. That's well done.
Sorry, I know I'm not really supposed to park up on there, but this is the main road.
See, you've done it just the same as everybody else has, which is fine.
Well, it's just the main road. I didn't want
to
be...
We would have been okay on there, but you've just taken the option to do which something that obviously everybody else does. That's fine. It's okay. How do you feel about that?
I don't know. A little bit shaky, but I mean, once I've done it a couple of times, it was easy.
Well,
so.
You've got more to think about.
Yeah.
Because you've got the added thing where you've got some traffic. You've also got less... good of a view, sort of stuff we've done before, and then people floating around.
Yeah, it's the whole, like, I mean, them kids, that was scary. I really did think he was going to jump out in front of his car.
It had that look, so you did exactly the right thing to hold back. But they're vulnerable road users. Mm. I was going to ask you, I was going to pull over and ask you the question about, have you ever felt like a vulnerable road user? But told me about it when you had the pram.
All the time.
You know, as a driver, we need to think about that, you know, and always remember that road users are vulnerable, and this thing is heavy, and if it hits people, it's...
Yeah. I'd much rather be in here than out there.
Yeah. But you're doing it, and I was going to ask you the supplemental question, what would you do if you were around road users like that, but you did it anyway. I suspect that's because you're a mother, I think that comes a bit more naturally than it does maybe for young lads.
It's just, I know what they're like, I know what kids are like. They like to jump out in front of cars, they don't see them as a danger.
No, well, their eye is fixed on
whatever it is
that they're heading for. Yeah.
Quaker kid.
It's hard.
And it was her fault, but he's never, ever been the same since. He's been...
Well, thankfully, the kid didn't die, so...
Well, no, I mean, she was fine. She didn't even have a mark on her, but, he was shaken, and they treat him horrible, the police. But, you know, at the end of the day, he could have done it deliberately, and they don't know that, and they didn't know he wasn't drinking, or... And that was the van.
What we're going to do now is try some right turns in with that.
Okay.
So what's the main difference, really?
Well, you have to be thinking more. You've got, it's the same, isn't it?
Well, when we're coming left, we don't really have to think too much about this other traffic.
Mm-hmm.
When we're turning right, we've got traffic coming towards us sometimes.
That's what I was going to say, but I didn't think it was right.
No, you're exactly right. Always say what you think. It doesn't matter if you're wrong. So we need to take that into account. Now, we can sometimes adjust our speed to allow traffic to move out the way.
Yeah.
And it's okay to do that, as long as you're not slowing somebody down behind you. There's that kid again. How's he got there? So we'll have a go at it. And same routine. Again, I'll talk you through it. When you're ready, off we go.
Yeah, those kids were scary. Really scary.
And what are you doing? Right in your blind spot.
Cheers, mate.
See now why you check. The They also reversed out of their driveway, which is a bit of a dangerous thing to do.
Yeah, you're normally supposed to reverse in, aren't you, so you can see more.
Excellent. Well done.
Oh, God, that bump can't be in. Well, I suppose it's no worse for the car than these speed bumps.
No, of course not. Choice. So you work out what he's doing.
Yeah, well, this is it.
Because obviously that's going to put us. At the end of this road, we'll take the road to the left, please. We'll let you do this one on your own. I'll jump in if you need me. But...
Oh, I am slowing someone.
No, that's fine. But I've done it for you, so just take it over again and into first gear. Yeah, don't worry about him. Oh.
That's why, because I saw him.
That's right, handbrake neutral. Deep breath and start the engine. And what we'll do this time is we'll put a bit more gas on.
Yeah.
Handbrake ready. Thanks to the clutch back down because we're not going just yet. So we're going to look for a gap, and then when you see the gap, then start to get ready. There you go. Excellent, well done. Good stuff. It's very difficult not to get fixated on the person sat behind you in, but can you see how it made you hurry?
Yes, and it made a stall, and I should have been more...
Yeah, it's fine.
I should have had more time, I should have took more time. Well, I had loads of space.
He just sat very quietly waiting, because he remembers what it was like to learn to drive.
He could have been a jerk and beeped at us or something like that.
Well, we would have made him wait longer then, if that
sat and did a dance instead.
Yeah. At the end of this road, we'll take the road to the right.
Okay.
So we've got a nice view to the right. Not so good to the left. Oh, obviously, we're just... You're in the perfect position. Are we going to be able to go, do you think?
I don't know, I can't see.
So let's take first gear. Okay, I'm just letting it trundle in. Last minute observations, can we go?
Yeah.
There you go, splendid. Well, you're at such a speed that if you decided you couldn't go, you could stop quite comfortably.
Yeah.
We'll take the next road on the right, please.
Back to the same road we're on before.
Oh, yeah. Go on the opposite loop.
With lots and lots of, like, free seeing space as well, so that'd be quite nice.
So the only concern now is the
cars coming in. Yeah.
Take an early look down the road, just to have a little bit of a scan. So are we going or stopping?
Going.
Nicely done.
Oh, a bit of a swan there.
That's okay.
Standing.
But the idea was right. You timed it to perfection. If you'd taken maybe just a smidgen more speed off...
Yeah, I could have gone in better.
Or you could have just stopped.
Yeah.
Either way.
Well, it's, you know, stopping requires more stopping of the car and...
Yeah, it's good practice, huh?
Well, yes, is it? Because that's what we're supposed to be doing, right?
But no, I mean, it's good to practice your speed and approach as well, to find yourself a gap to go in.
Yeah.
We'll take this next road on the right. What we'll do is we'll stop as though there was somebody coming. So think about where the nose of the car needs to be. So we'll bring it to a stop just before you start clutch down. That's it. Still braking. So we just allowed that to run a little bit too far forward.
I should have started earlier.
That's okay. I've taken the control. I'll hand it back to you now.
Oh, didn't realise I had done it.
That's nicely done. It's just getting everything in the right order, and it just takes practice, that's all. We were nearly right there. I just didn't want to let you stall twice.
I didn't realise that you had even done it. These roads are hard with the bendy bits in them.
Yes, they're difficult places to negotiate around because you don't know what's around the next corner. We follow the road to the right,
Yes.
That's it. Good.
Now we're all right. I really should have checked my shoulder more.
No, not once you're on the move. It's only when you're moving away from a standstill.
Oh, okay.
Or perhaps at traffic lights, that kind of stuff.
Well, yeah, because then it's the person's, their responsibility to check, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, no, obviously you have to check it.
Yes, but... Well, yeah, when you're moving away from a stop, that's when people can get into your blind spots. But once you're on the move like this, people can't get in there.
No, of course not.
Not easily, anyway.
Well, my bikes do, though, don't they?
They can, if they're... A lot of dead ends here. At the end of this road, we'll take the road to the right.
Oh, it's a hill.
It is. But remember how good we are at hill starts.
Uh-huh. I can't see where there's another turn in.
Yeah, it's...
There is, so I'm not going to make
well
it.
Well done. So we can hardly see anything at all, so we're probably going to have to stop. But I can just ride for over the brick. Into first. That's it. Now then, set the gas. I've got the brick. Set the gas, find the bike. Bit more gas. Not quite enough gas. But that's fine. Handbrake neutral. And we'll start the engine. Let's start the engine. Good. So this is a little bit steeper hill, so in the first, a bit more gas this time. Quite a little bit more. That's great.
Handbrake off, yeah?
Yep.
God, this is a busy road.
And then we can just creep forward. Just control the speed. That's brilliant. Now this gives you loads of time to have a look. Just, that's it, good, well done. Trundling, you can be looking. Fabulous.
Yeah, we're great.
Now, do you see how your clutch control comes into play there?
Yeah.
You were able to regulate the speed of the car.
Just with the clutch. Instead
to
of
give yourself plenty of time to look. Good, well done. Stalls don't count, by the way.
Good.
At all.
What, even on the test?
No.
Really?
Well, it depends on how you do it.
Well, how you do it, yeah.
That's
obviously,
right.
If you stall in the middle of a road with cars coming, you're going to get a feel similar to that.
It's more to do with what you do afterwards. How you control things.
How you correct yourself.
If you just go handbrake, neutral, start the engine, and take control of it, everything's fine. It's getting a bit warm, that.
It is. It was cold before, though.
I know. Find a happy medium in this.
Jonathan on the right.
At the end of the road... At the end of the road, we'll turn right. I was going to say, let's pick a bit of speed up. You cannot really over these humps, can you?
I'm too scared of these roads, too, with the people and stuff.
Very difficult. So again, that determines the speed that you're coming, doesn't it? Okay. Just slotted into first gear. Still your right foot over the brake. That's it. Brilliant. Now then, we use the handbrake if a pause becomes a wait.
It should be okay though after this guy, yeah. Oh, you're a bit close, lady.
She was a little.
Oh, you're a bit close as well. Goodness me. What is with everybody?
It's obviously a corner that they're normally cut. That's excellent. Well done.
That was easier. Should I be practicing putting my foot on the floor from the clutch as well?
We haven't had a long run. When you're, like, say if we were on that road there, we'll turn left at the end of this road. If you're on
this
that
road
there, yeah. If you're on that road over there, yeah. But on these little short stretches here, you're ready to change on the up and down. So again, this is a nice speed to determine whether we can go or not.
Yep.
Well done. Perfect timing. Give it a speed where you could have stopped or gone.
Yeah. Oh, that is lovely.
Also nice not to be banging over speed humps as well.
It's quite a busy road, but you know, where it outweighs the benefits.
And up in the third.
What's the speed limit?
Tell me. What do you reckon?
I would say 30.
You're absolutely right.
It's built a barrier, isn't it?
It is.
bet you all the people behind me don't want to do 30.
No. There's only learner drivers and people being followed by the police to do 30.
This is it. The reason I'm slowing is because I couldn't see.
It's fine. Not a problem. We'll take the next road on the left. Now again, if we control our speed on the way in, there's a good chance those lights might change. Just like that.
Oh, come on. You could have waited the extra 2 seconds it took me to turn the corner, mate.
Oh, no. That would never do. So what do the signs tell you?
It's not my right of way.
That's good.
I shouldn't say right of way, should I?
Priority. We'll let you off on that one. So you would need to wait behind this line if there was somebody coming, but obviously there isn't.
Which would be the same as stopping at a junction.
Pretty much. Pretty much. They obviously have a problem with joyriders around here.
Speed humps,
absolutely everywhere.
Slowly in third.
So, who has priority here?
He does.
So, see if we can time our approach so that we don't have to stop. Maybe a lower gear? That's nicely done.
She has to wait for me, right?
She should.
I'm very worried that she wasn't even looking in my direction.
I was just going to say, you've done exactly the right thing because she wasn't looking. So you need to be putting yourself in a position where you can stop if she just stepped out, which looked like
she would have, yeah. I have had one almost before, so.
So it's all about, really, I mean, it's being a good driver is all about time and space. You've got to give yourself time to do things and space to do them in.
Yeah. It's when people look at the car, like, you know, have I got time to run out in front of this car?
Well, you do get a bit of that, you know. You get people pulling out in front of you because you've got L plates on. They just assume you're travelling slow.
Or they just assume that someone's going to step in for you if you go.
Oh, I know where I am. Isn't this where the baths is?
Is it?
I think.
Oh, I don't know.
It's a blast from the past of my youth. We used to come down and Blythe baths every Sunday morning.
That's a dead end.
It's not indicated that, is it? Well done. There weren't any signs to say this was a cul-de-sac.
No, but I could see it.
Yep, well done. Thank you. Job for me now, look.
I'm in third. I really shouldn't have been in third to go around that corner.
Well, it was very wide open, and third will take you at the speed that we were travelling. But second would have been ideal, but it was all done in a bit of a hurry.
Yeah, I think I'm going to come down a gear anyway because it's.
Yeah, we're back into the big speed humps, aren't we?
This car.
At the end of the road, what's happening here, do you suppose?
I'm sure that these people. She's not even looking. Oh, I'm not.
Yeah, this is the right speed.
Can I go up on the curb?
Well, you're not really faced with a choice, are you?
No, because
it's a lower curb, so that's fine. People are just unreal.
I know.
We'll go right at the end of here. That's nicely done. I mean, it's fortunate that the curbs were lowered, otherwise.
Well, I would have had to stop. Well, not that there's a big hardship in stopping.
Well, no.
Where do you want me to go now?
We'll just keep following the road ahead.
Just because there's kiddies again.
I was going to say that this is the right speed, isn't it?
Yep.
Because whilst you could see them on the way in, once you were hidden behind that van, you don't know if they've stood up and
they could have, yeah, exactly. So I know you're supposed to. What do you say? Look under the car to see if
there. If you can, yeah. It's a guide. Don't base everything on that. But
I wouldn't like to.
We'll take the next left.
Okay. I wouldn't like to base anything on it because kids are very, very unpredictable to things.
Well, they are.
There's obviously not anything coming from there, so I've just come in slow.
It'd be nice to find a practice area that doesn't have so many humps, and we'll follow the road ahead.
Okay. gets his used to them.
Did you see the ice cream van parked up on the left there? An ice cream van in that cul-de-sac.
Should have.
No, it's what I'm just saying. I just wanted to, I thought you'd glance down there. Wherever there's an ice cream van,
there's children.
And children behaving erratically.
Ice cream! I want ice cream!
Pretty much. At the end of this road, we'll take the road to the right, please. So how much can we see here?
Barely anything.
Oh, yes. Yeah, so.
Also going to speed hunt the slummer progress down.
Which gear do you think we'll be using here?
Probably one.
Yeah.
Are we going to get over it?
Yeah, oh, yeah, no bother at all. So I'd just be slotting it in the first now, while you're doing your observations. What do you think?
Blue car as well.
Okay, let's stick the hand right on them because the pause has become a bit.
It's even worse.
Yeah. Well, you can have a look there. He's travelling beyond the speed limit, isn't he?
Yeah.
But he slowed down now.
He wasn't before.
No. So you've done the right thing anyway. But while he's coming, we can perhaps think about getting ready. How did that feel?
Easy. Much easier. I could probably have done it a bit faster, but I wasn't sure.
No, that's absolutely right to do with the speed you did at. At the end of this road, we'll take the road leading to the right, please. So again, how much can we see?
Nothing.
Well, you're almost certainly going to have to stop, aren't we, really?
Yeah.
Because you just can't see until you get right to the end. But trundle in and select first, so that you're ready to go if the opportunity. So from here you can stop or go. But we're on a little bit of a hill, so we'll need the handbrake this time. Plenty of gas. That's it. Got a bit more. Always better off with a little bit too much on than not enough. That's absolutely whiz bang. So, in terms of a hill start, if I was to ask you there.
Nailed.
Yeah. Okay. That's a 10 then. Nailed. Excellent. Very good indeed. That's nice.
Bunker. Cut the camera, was there? Sorry.
So, yeah, he shouldn't have pulled out there.
No, he shouldn't. I could have been going way faster than I was. And I was changing gears, which would have meant I would have been. I'm not, though, because I'm not daft. I see exactly what he was going to do.
It's difficult sometimes, isn't it? You look at people doing stuff like that, you think, well, why did he do that, do you think? Is it because he's a wanker?
Mostly, yeah. These pumps are
but what me. Else might happen, do you think? We'll go left here. So you've got plenty of time to work out what's happening here. I'll let you get on with this one on your own.
Oh, wait.
Nice,
but there might not be, so I thought I'd best not give it a bit.
Absolutely right. What I'd like you to do is to find a convenient place to pull over on the left. Well done.
Well, the brakes are a little bit...
And relax. So the guy pulled out in front of you?
Yeah.
It's... We all get annoyed with everybody else on the road these days because people don't do what they should be doing. So he shouldn't have gone there because you were clearly coming. A, you're a learner driver and you shouldn't be spooking learner drivers. And B, he didn't really have the space to do it.
He didn't look?
No. So we've got him down as a wanker. But, and maybe he is, but how about, what if I said to you, well, what if he's just had a phone call from somewhere to say that his kid's ill and he's...
Oh, I know. This is why I didn't give him any... I thought best to be hesitant and then just in case I had to stop, you know, because last thing I want is an accident.
Sure.
In a lunar car.
So, I mean, he may be in a rush to go and pick up a sickly child or whatever. So, if you get that kind of message and you're making that journey and you're what we call suspending normal road courtesies, it's very difficult. What could you do, do you think? How would it make you feel if you were driving?
You wouldn't be paying attention.
No, so it's... is it something you might need to think about if you're making that kind of... So we chatted about a little earlier about journey planning. You know, if you're going, oh, God, yes, you want to get there quickly, but you want to get there.
Yeah. So the last thing you want is to be driving around.
If anything really is affecting it, whether you're tired, whether you're irritable, whether you're in a rush to do something, you just need to really have a think about, ooh, how is my frame of mind going to affect the way I drive? Because the most important thing is that you get to where you want to be. Anyway, that's not the main reason I stopped you. So those last, let's have a look at the last three junctions that we've done. Mm-hmm. If I was to ask you to grade yourself from 1 to 10, where 1 was where it all went fairly completely wrong and 10 was that you absolutely nailed everything, where would you place yourself?
The hill start thing was awesome.
I couldn't have done that
better. I need to be a little bit slower, I think, definitely, because obviously I need to give myself a little bit more of a legacy. Like you see, I'm getting to the last minute and thinking, oh God, I've got to be doing this. So it wasn't so much like that now. It was more like that at the start.
Yes, I was just going
to
say,
the more times I did it, it was easier to do.
How would you compare it to the first one you did?
Oh, definitely. Massive improvement.
So which areas do you think you might need to be thinking about on the next time we come up to a junction like that to make it better?
Probably slowing down a little bit earlier. Okay. You know, thinking about where everything is and where I need to be and, you know, watching to make sure that there's no one coming.
So what do you need more of on the run-in?
Well, you know, less speed.
More time.
More time.
Let's have a go at that, shall we?
Okay.
Happy?
Yeah.
On you go.
Okay.
Have to challenge the behaviour, as you see. I'm a wanker. The reality is, he was a wanker. But we can't think that. Quick check on the blind spot. I'll take the blame and I distracted you. It was a wanker. He shouldn't have gone.
It's alright. I did slow down just in case he decided that he was going to, like, you know.
Well, it's good. The body language of his car told you he was going to go for it, didn't it? Really?
The body language of his car told you he was a wanker. Oh, dear me.
Now, this is a more modern development and they tend to have these curly roads.
Yeah, they've got no middle lanes either.
No, that's right.
God, you can't see. This is massive.
So, anything you can do to counteract that, do you think?
Look around it.
That's it, exactly right.
I think parking on the path's just sort of like a new thing for everybody to do.
This is a nice area,
I think,
area,
this
isn't
is
it?
A cul-de-sac.
This is where you need to buy a house. Isn't it lovely? I think you might be right. What we'll do is we'll just... Can we go up there? Or is that a cul-de-sac too? I think you can. Yeah, go on. Oh, no.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
That's all right. What I'll do is we'll point her up that way and then I'll reverse it back around. Just bring this to a nice gentle stop. But I tell you what, do you want to do it?
Yeah, sure.
I'm here ready for you. So handbrake and then into reverse.
Handbrake and then into reverse?
Yep. That's it.
You can't use a palm for that one.
No, it's tricky, you've got to have it. That's it. I remember before when we were trundling away with no gas on?
Yeah.
Try that, because we're on a bit of a hill.
Oh, so I can just use the handbrake?
Yeah. Good look all round. Obviously, it's difficult to see when you're going backwards, so we need to go slower. And we're just going to follow the line of that curb around. So which way do you think you may need to steer? Exactly right. Good all-round observation all the time.
Oh, it is on a hill, like, isn't it?
It is. Well done. That's good. Keep checking all round. You look at the kind
there,
of house.
I can see the curb now. There we go. I feel a bit happier now. I can see the curb.
That's not a bad effort at all. Now, what you'd normally be doing is you'd be making most of your observation rearwards and
so
glancing around
at
these. That's fine. First time we've done it. In the first, and off you go. So, you look at the kind of housing that there is here. What do you think we could be expecting? Sort of people buy these kind of houses.
Fast cars.
Families. There are some nice cars, though.
Yeah. No, these are half family houses. Yeah. They're lovely.
So
cars.
There'll be kids. I bet these aren't 100,000.
No, these are brand new builds. I don't think that came all the way off.
It did. Well done. That's beautiful control. Left at the end, please.
Just like it. keep steering wheel back to straight because it's all twisty. It's going to come off, isn't it?
So this makes life a bit awkward, doesn't it?
Just a bit. Well, maybe I should buy a house on this estate just to make me driving that a little bit better.
But again, you've done the right thing by holding the speed right down to give you time to do what you need to do.
No markings, so you don't know where you're supposed to be or anything. Yeah,
tricky. Very tricky. I'm going to just follow it around on the left.
Yeah.
It is lovely here, though, isn't it?
Yeah, I wouldn't mind one of these ones. I think I might point Craig in this direction. There's one for sale as well.
Rook Matthews, sir. At the roundabout, we'll turn then. Take the first road to the left, please. The first exit.
The left?
Yes, please. So again, base your speed on what you can see.
See.
Oh, you make all the decisions here yourself. So, scale of 1 to 10?
9 3/4.
Splendid. What would you improve?
To be honest, I probably would have stopped there just, you know, to give us the practice. You know what I mean? Because that's sure. Like a third time I've been able to go when there's been nobody there.
But you were in a position where you could have stopped quite easily.
Yeah, this is it. I mean, I was slow enough.
You've got the time and you've got the space. That's the important thing.
I like this road.
It's nice. It's certainly better than the ones we've been on.
Yeah. There's no
humps. At the roundabout, I'd like you to take the road to the right, please. Well done. Like I say, you were wishing for a stop, and now you've got one.
Oh, I'm not liking the proximity of his car.
Well, it's just about right there. Tyres and tarmac between us and him. So who has priority here?
They do.
No, we have priority over them.
Do we?
We do. We give way to these people, they give way to us. That's good, brother. Good, well done. Don't worry about him. And here we go. That's it. Excellent, well done.
It was a tight roundabout.
It is. What am I going to do with this? Oh, it's moving. Okay.
I didn't think it got out of my way.
That's nice. I like that the way you've controlled that in the way, and we're not holding anybody up behind, so. And you've arrived just to. That'll save you fuel.
Really?
Oh, absolutely. Harsh acceleration, harsh braking costs fuel.
Oh. I was a little bit heavy on the brake there at the roundabout, but that's because I wasn't expecting that car. People do come fast around these corners, don't
they? Yes, they do. We'll go ahead of the roundabout. So no signals on approach.
We are the.
We give way to people.
Yeah,
coming
but he's coming straight over, so. Yeah,
exactly right.
So is he. Oh, bless. Malcolm Gardner, that's my mum's driving instructor.
Mm-hmm. Follow the road ahead.
He has a very, very good pass rate.
At the roundabout, we'll take the road to the left, the first exit.
The first one?
Yes, please. Scrub that, we'll take the third exit to the right. Sorry. So that's it, indicate the right. Alright, approaching the speed where you can see what's happening. I lost my bearings there for a minute.
Bit heavy on the brake.
That's fine. The decision making part of it is all perfect. That's all we're looking at.
Oh, are we, lady? That was mean of her. But to be honest, you know.
It is, it's frustrating when that happens because. You clearly could have gone earlier had she signalled.
But obviously she didn't.
But I'm afraid it's becoming a forgotten art signalling. But you can see how just doing that would have made life easy. Not this exit, the one after.
Yeah, I thought you said third. I wasn't sure though.
So once we're past that one, mirrors, signal at the left. Another wanger.
Is he not watching us, like?
This fella just pulled straight out.
Oh, no, he had...
Didn't look at all.
I was going pretty slow, but to be... Yeah, you're right, I could have been, like, proper stamping on the accelerator for all he knows.
This is true. And follow the road ahead. So, yeah, we're not worried about the brain being a little bit firm. It's all about the routine and the decision-making on the way in. I think that's the baths there.
Yeah.
If I'm not mistaken. I do like the speed humps here, don't they?
Yeah, they do. That's very true. Right, you weren't looking. People have no awareness, really, do they?
No.
It's such a shame as well, because it causes so many accidents.
Well, we kind of blindly just trundle about without a thought of the consequences of our actions.
Mm-hmm.
So what are we looking for here?
People running out again.
Yeah. Perhaps car doors.
Cars. People pulling off the drives.
Yep.
Couldn't get your car door much wider than that woman had it before. That was quite interesting.
It's a downside of 3-door cars. You open the door, it sticks right
out
the
yeah.
Road.
Of course, because you've got to be able to get people out the back, haven't you? So.
And again, this is a 30-mile-an-hour limit, but you wouldn't want to be hitting these speed humps at 30-mile-an-hour, would you?
Not at all. It says in the book that you've got to do it at a reduced speed for greater control of the car. So, you know, I'm going to go with what the book says.
Oh, yeah.
And obviously what you say.
Well, of course.
Because you're always right.
That goes without saying. Hang on, I thought I was a bloke, so I was always wrong.
No.
Isn't that how it works? That's what I was led to believe. So, vehicles either side of the road. Someone who's coming the other way, who has priority?
Oh, God. Doesn't it not depend on how far the person's through?
Yeah. Who gets there first,
yeah.
Really? But even if you have priority, you know, like here, we have priority.
If I was right the way through it, someone wouldn't expect me to reverse all the way back up the road, but the...
Well, they shouldn't.
No. And... I'm just going to... He's not down at the second, because there's a big bend, and
yep. Absolutely. You've got to put yourself... Actually, as it happens, the railway's closed.
But is it, though?
Yeah, they've cut the lights down.
Oh, right.
I've just noticed. So they should have taken the sign down, too, but it was the right choice because it was on a blind bend.
Mm.
So, good. Well done. Follow up to the road ahead. I haven't been here for years. Newsom.
This is where Craig wants to live. The nicer place, apparently.
He's looked nice.
Yeah, there's a few for sale in here. One of them, like I say, was 100 grand. It was a 4-bed.
Does
it was 110 or something, maybe.
Oh, and follow the road around to the left. But the gardens are all tiny. That's always a good sign.
Well, this is it. It means people actually take care of the houses.
Good. Well done.
New Dalrymple. That's it, there was a view for Zealand there. Because we've
put the around to the right.
Put Dalrymple into the search engine, it brings up New Dalrymple also.
And we'll go ahead at the roundabout. Second exit. That's it, good. Well done. Once we're past that, that's it. I'll shut up, you were doing it. That's tight.
Waiting for you to tell me whether you wanted me to do that or not. That's why I hesitated on the gas.
It's one of the problems of not really known the area 100%.
Yeah, having to hesitate at every bend just in case I have to take it.
I get wait to get around and get a clear view to remember which way to go. So that's always a good sign, isn't it? When the gardens are tidy.
Yeah, well, this is it. It means people actually care about how the house looks. A lot of the houses we looked at were like that. And I was quite impressed.
And these are obviously being council houses, but it looks like they're all being sold.
Yeah, well, this is it. That's what they're all ex-council. There's a few of them around ours as well. And the price has significantly dropped, but I mean, I don't see why, because they're really well taken care of. Mm-hmm. I mean, people wouldn't be able to buy them if they didn't have the money.
At the mini roundabout, we'll follow the road ahead, which is where the buses come from.
So I don't need to.
No signal on the way in, that's right. No signal on the way out. Although there is, it's the first exit we're taking, so you could have signalled there. That's good. And I think I can remember where we're from here. I think.
Where to?
Delaval.
Oh, we're going home? Cool.
Yeah, why not? Travel that way. I don't want to do too much all at once.
Okay.
Yeah, we made good progress. How do you feel?
Good. I was nervous at first, but I'm all right now, so.
Well, it's natural to be nervous. The roundabout, we'll take the road to the right. As you can see, it's the second exit.
Alright,
it's a little bit early, but better too early than too late.
No, I just want to pull down a gear and just, you know, in case I had to stop or anything. Because, you know.
Oh, yeah. That sort of stuff's just practice. You know, the smoothness comes with doing it more and more. And it's, you know, there's also the fact that a lot of traffic around you at that point, so you know, you feel the need to hurry in those circumstances, I think. But we all do.
Hello? Was that wind?
No. It was a snatch on the gear. Pull of the gear lever again a little bit.
Oh, sorry.
Just made your, it's fine. Just made your other hand go a bit wobbly at the same time.
I thought it was the wind, I caught the car, I was like, ah! We were flying off.
So what I'll do is, tonight I'll pull up Google Maps and see if I can find some better practice areas, because that looked okay, but the speed ups are just, it means we can't get any speed up in between to be doing the work on the gears if we want.
Yeah.
That's fine. All in good time.
Which one's the speed one? Is it the one on the right?
The what, sorry?
The speed. Speed.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, I thought it was the right one. I was looking at that one, it's saying 20. I'm saying, I'm sure I was going 40.
Yes, perhaps I should have pointed that out. How remiss.
No, I did assume that it was that one, so.
It is, quite right.
Can you go from 4 to 1?
You can.
Right.
You can. But it's a roundabout that we're coming to, so it'll depend on what we can see. So you can see there's a sign for the roundabout. Are you going to take the road to the left in that roundabout?
Yeah.
Oh, you know your way back now.
I just didn't want to win the trading estate. These roads are dodgy as anything.
There's a lot of holes, that's for sure.
Bumps. Holes. Children. Lots of children.
Helpful if they'd indicate it.
Obviously they didn't fancy it. It's taking the car forever to get back up to the speed, so because I forgot to put it in the second and first.
At third probably would have been okay.
Yeah. I think I did third in the last one and it was alright. Yeah. But obviously it's taking a time to crawl up through.
Coming up a little bit of a hill too. So but that, I mean, that's fine too. So.
Because you should be in a lower gear for a start.
But that's okay. So as we're coming in, that car wasn't indicating, but his position really told you that he was
going that way. Yeah.
It was good.
I saw him coming up on the right and I thought, oh yeah, I should be fine because he'll shield us.
Correct. Correct.
Is that horrible?
No. It's true.
Someone else pulls out the key, he'll get hit and lobby me. Just use him as shield. I've seen people do that with lorries.
Yeah.
Using them as a shield. This was a 50, right?
You tell me.
Yeah, it is. I would actually say it's probably more than that.
It's actually a 60, this one. It was 50 on the other road, but as we turned into this one, there was a national speed limit sign.
No, I didn't spot that.
So that makes this one a 60.
Didn't spot that one.
You always look, as you're coming off a roundabout...
I know what this means.
Go on then.
No crossing on their side.
Correct.
I can use it though.
That's right.
They can't though.
That's right.
I am learning. That means we're just speeding now, usually.
Indeed.
Just in case.
It's very difficult to tell. How tight it is, because you can't see.
I know how tight it is, but only because I know this road yet. If I was someone coming up from some... That's not that big.
It's not that bad, is it? However, if you were doing 70 or 80 mile an hour...
That would be big, yeah. I need to start spending some money around here getting these roads repaired.
They're not good, are they? They aren't. So they've just sort of patched it up. As soon as you get a frost, it just rips that up.
Yeah, well, this is it. They don't do the proper resurfacing. The one down back of Flon on the new road is like totally ridiculously bad. I'm going a nice speed, I just come off the gas completely from doing that.
Yeah. And you say again, it trundles at that speed.
I've got a bit of a tail back, but I don't care.
Sorry. They can make their way past if they want to.
Well, this is it. Plus, you know.
I mean, do you think you could be going faster around here? Do you think that would be sensible?
Not really, not if I skid, because there's a lot of loose stones on the road as well.
Absolutely right. Well done. But now we've got a nice open road.
Yeah.
Off we go. I'm back up through the gears. You're really smooth, those gear changes now. It's because you're allowing yourself the time.
It's because I'm not panicking now.
Yeah, well, it's practice.
Because I didn't know where we were going either, which kind of helps us a little bit.
Follow the road ahead, which is the second exit.
Yeah, straight.
And again, based on all of what you can see. Think about the gear this time as well, though. Maybe take a smidgen more speed off a little earlier. Clutch smoothly back up. That's it, clutch back up. That's it. You see how it started to just pull you back a little, so would it just help you to trundle in a bit more?
Yeah.
So, signal for him.
Yeah, sorry. Oops, sorry, Mr. Policeman. Feel free to stop me.
At the head of the next round, but...
I don't like this round. I don't think anyone who likes this round about.
Can we give way to people going that way? They can wait on us.
Yeah, we're good.
So, well done. Good stuff.
It's making me look around a bit more as well, rather than actually looking up here. Because I can see that there's people behind us. I don't need to know what they're doing. It's mainly...
Exactly right.
I don't really care what they're doing.
Unless they're going to overtake you, of course.
Obviously, yes. If anyone to overtake me on here, they would be absolutely stupid.
Well, that doesn't mean they won't do it.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, this is Sea Devil. There's lots of stupid people here. I thought he was going to pull out there. What a stupid place to park. There's a reason I did that though, because there's a blind entrance to it. This street.
I used to visit somebody up here, I can't remember where it was now. At the roundabout, we'll take the road to the right, the third exit.
Okay.
Again. Oh my word.
Hello. This is what this road's like though.
You can't believe anybody would do that. Good.
Oh, come on.
Good decision. Now in the first. Yeah, if he'd signalled.
Well, what are you doing? What are you doing?
It's frustrating, isn't it? When you're ready. Couldn't really change gear because you didn't have enough room.
No.
We'll take the next road on the left, please.
Yeah, I'm good. Still pull it down a bit, I think, just in case.
Yeah, best to be safe. That's nice.
There's no road humps here anymore, I don't think.
There's chicanes, but no humps.
There's no one there. It's
good.
All good.
Splendid. But again, there's only now. Like, yeah, but we're already in the gap, so there's not a lot we could do about it. Yeah, I think you've got the speed about right here, haven't you?
Sorry, you didn't prompt me. I just assumed we were going home.
I was going to go at the end of the road and go around the loop, but this will do.
Sorry. You can go down that estate if you want.
No, it's fine.
No.
So the entrance to your street is a bit...
Daddy.
Wild with that hum, so obviously we're going to need to take some speed off and probably use first gear. Again, right foot over the brake.
Oh.
A little bit early with the gear change, that's all right. Again, still right off, right foot over the brake. So you decide you're going to go on and then squeeze on. That's it. Nice. I chose to just walk down the middle of the road.
They do. Just making sure. Because that happens.
Yeah. And we'll pull him either outside your place or...
Do you want us to park him?
Yeah, kind of.
Oh, how are you, mate?
That's it. Right for all the brick. Ready with the clutch. I got it.
Forgot it. Sorry.
That's all right.
And we're rolling.
Handbrake neutral. Well done. And relax.